Welcome to the party, folks. Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is DFW Real Estate Weekly. If you're catching us live, we need to know what you need to know. Give us a call or text us 214-310-0008. We've got the full studio today, folks. We've got microphones everywhere. Full Price Courtney running the boards. We've even got producer Phoenix. How about that title, buddy? Producer Phoenix, the intern, in the back of the studio. We've got the English wonder himself, the Yanni Donny, as always, yep. And the one and only, there's only one Patrick Gleros, folks. What's his NMLS number? Oh! Oh! You didn't know it.
I can't believe
it. Oh, my gosh. Look what is happening. He's Phoenix. You know this already.
Oh, my gosh.
Ian's never been more proud of anything than the way he says Patrick Gleros Mortgage Team's NMLS number, okay?
I was doing research for something later in the show.
Given the opportunity to nail it, he did not nail it.
I was in the middle of research.
We'll try again some other time. Wow. Welcome to the studio, Patrick.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
All right, we're going to dig in deep to what the heck is happening. We're not going to spend tons and tons of time on technical mortgage talk, but we are going to talk about what's happening with mortgage and how it impacts you as a buyer, a seller, a homeowner. We're going to dig in deeper as we go, but you feel free to lean into that microphone, Patrick, and touch on any topic you like. Ian's going to get us carried away here with a quick live read.
Yeah, because this first segment is brought to you by Patrick Gleros and his team at Cardinal Financial. If you're looking to get a mortgage, if you're looking to refinance, maybe you're wanting an investment property, Patrick is a great first place to go. You can go right to his website, patrickgleros.com, G-L-A-R-O-S. You can start an application right there. NMLS number 308804. See, nailed it.
There you go.
Great job. Proud of you. Proud of you. Now, if you were doing that live read, what would you? I'm just kidding. It can be a little nerve wracking to read an ad for someone when they're staring at you. So I would give you a 8.7 out of 10. Only deduction is because when given an opportunity to share your favorite thing, you just weren't ready in the on deck circle. But we'll do better next time.
I don't believe in nerves, Todd.
Laser eyes can be intimidating.
As the coach of this team, I'm going to say that's on me. I'll take responsibility for that. No, folks.
Yeah, you're right. Do better.
You're right. I'm wrong. Send us your questions, folks. 214-310-0008. 214-310-0008. Or all day and all night at toddtremonteteam.com. Click the radio tab. You'll find Patrick's info and all of our other pros and professionals that we're talking to here on the show. Here's the deal. We do the show every Saturday, 3 to 4. You can catch the podcast anytime, wherever you get podcasts, DFW Real Estate Weekly. And we do it to help add clarity for you in the complete fog of information all around the media. So there's all sorts of people saying the market's up, the market's down, there's tons of opportunity, there's no opportunity. And the truth is usually somewhere in the middle. We are here to help you sort it all out and make the best decision you can for your family, your finances, and yourself when it comes to buying, selling, investing, or simply enjoying wherever it is that you live. So let us know how we can help. 214-310-0008. And if you haven't checked your property value recently, I think you're doing it wrong. You want to go to toddtremonteteam.com, click that home valuation tab or the seller's tab. You can find out what your home would sell for right now, what your estimate of equity is, and then you can track that month by month going forward, which we believe responsible homeowners do. Okay, let's get into it. And at any point, Full Price Courtney, if you want the mic, you just raise your right hand like a ball boy or a ball girl at a tennis match. Okay, there it is. Oh, that was just a test. That she's not, she doesn't really want a mic. She was just testing her signal. All right, lead the way, Yanni Donny.
So Courtney actually found an article.
You see how he said actually as if he didn't originally expect her to? Like, she actually found it.
Like, I don't produce the show!
Back to you.
Why am I, that wasn't even intended like that. Courtney found an article.
So proud
of you. She actually did. And the article was about a new startup company that promises
brilliant idea coming.
Right, you ready for this? This is a great headline.
I'm ready.
New real estate startup promises half price mortgage rates as home loans climb.
You sit on a throne of lies.
What they're talking about is assumable loans. They're talking about how a homeowner that got locked in at a 3.5, 3.75, maybe a little bit less rate can sell their home, and this company is linking buyers and sellers together to create an assumable loan.
All right, but let's do a quick lightning round of one question. Patrick Glarus, broad estimate of how many people this will apply to?
At least 7.
Okay.
No, there can be some validity to that. There are certain mortgages that are assumable, and based on where the market has been over the last few years, there's a lot of people sitting in those potentially assumable mortgages that could be taken over by a new buyer. The way that this assumption works is a new buyer comes in, they can take over the existing mortgage, assuming they qualify for it, and resume that existing rate. Here's the deal. If you're sitting at the 2.5% interest rate, why are you going to leave it and move on to the next one? Now, that's all part of the bigger
picture. I got answers for that question.
That's part of the bigger picture conversation. But it's not as simple as somebody coming in and saying, oh, well, I just want to give you my 2.5. There has to be a give and a take.
Yeah.
Well, and a certain trigger or catalyst that would make somebody want to do that. I think that's what makes the number smaller on top of those that would actually qualify for the assumption.
So the part of what it says in here is it says, because we're a licensed real estate brokerage, we're able to identify the homes that are eligible for assumable loans. So what makes it eligible or
ineligible?
Ineligible.
Sure. Nailed it. FHA mortgage. So they can do a deed search and find out who holds an FHA mortgage on the property. That is their base. There's also VA loans that are assumable, but those are only assumable by other veterans. So your large pool and base is those that are in FHA mortgages at a rate that's attractive enough for somebody that would want to assume that. And on the flip side, pay a premium to the seller. That's the benefit to the seller.
Right.
Is somebody might come in and pay a premium for that price so that they can assume that lower interest rate.
All right, let me do some rapid fire relevant points and facts here. And you guys feel free to jump in, but I don't want to spend the bulk of the show talking about the technicalities of mortgage. I want people to understand, is there some opportunity for them or not? Now, look, I'm not picking on this startup. It's going to be a good idea for a small portion of the audience, but great. Lots of businesses serve a small portion of the audience. We're not here for everyone. We want to have conversations with lots of people. We'll serve you if we're the best to serve you. If not, we'll connect you with someone who can. And Patrick runs his business the same way. Here's the deal. If the loan is assumable, you still have to qualify. So the VA loan is a great example. If you're not a veteran, you're not going to qualify. FHA, same thing. If your credit's not good, if your income's not as good, if you don't qualify for the mortgage anyway, this isn't like finding a mortgage where you couldn't otherwise find one. This is finding an old, better rate than you could currently find. To Patrick's point, that person's probably going to want a premium for that because they're probably, and on the next stop, going to have to get into a higher interest rate. Now, you can only pay a premium to the extent that you have control over your purchase amount, meaning if you're borrowing for the difference, if they have a $200,000 mortgage on a home that was a $300,000 home, and now that's $550,000, and you need to borrow $300,000 more or whatever the case is, that loan is now going to be a second mortgage, which is somewhat complicated.
100%.
At a higher rate, which is somewhat not ideal. And there's still going to be an appraisal that factors in all these lenders and how much they're willing to loan you, and they may not let that buyer pay you the premium that you would want for your rate. So I don't want to dig any deeper on that necessarily right now, but I do want to say, look, if you know someone and they have a super low rate that is truly assumable and you can qualify, and some real estate agents and lenders and other folks can help you put that together, that's great. It's just not going to happen for the vast majority of buyers and sellers right now. We can talk a lot more about how current high interest rate loans are annoying, but still potentially a huge advantage because you have a lot less competition from other buyers, you have sellers that are more likely to work with you, and you're not necessarily having to pay the massive premium of competing with 10, 20, 30 other buyers. We've been talking about that for months and months and months on the show, but if you have questions, how could people call you, Patrick, if they have specific mortgage-related questions?
Call me directly anytime at the office at 972-728-3420, 972-728-3420.
You can find him online at patrickglaros.com, and as always, if you forget any of that, just online like my son says.
ToddTremonteTeam.com.
Now, we'll keep running with Patrick throughout the show. We'll dig really deep in the second half on some interesting new loan opportunities, as well as if you're with us because you, like us, love homes on land, We're going to dig in with Patrick a little bit later on some loan opportunities that might benefit you as you buy, improve, maybe even expand a home with some acreage. But before that,
let me tell you about DP Lambert at Goosehead Insurance. I'd reached out to DP recently and just had a conversation with him about home and auto stuff, and he was like, man, rates are just crazy right now.
Same.
I'm going to double check everything for you. My odds are you're going to be best to stick with what you already have.
Told me the same thing.
And it was. It was the best thing, and that's what he did. He made it happen.
For us, saved $1,641, even after he was trying to be very, very careful and not get my hopes up. So love the honesty. Really like the savings.
DP.Lambert, L-A-M-B-E-R-T, at goosehead.com is how you can reach out to him. You can call him at 214-838-5684. And as Todd just said, all our recommended pros and vendors can be found on the website. Go to ToddTremontyTeam.com, click the radio tab, and you will find them all right there. Let me talk to you about investing in real estate.
I'll let you. I'll do it.
Talk to me about what are the biggest mistakes people do when they are getting into investing in real estate.
Let's do a quick pop quiz with Patrick. Patrick, what percentage of people that say they are investors are actually investing in real estate?
I'm going to take the under at, once again, 7%.
7 is a good number. Nailed it. Okay, so that's the first thing is before we talk about the biggest mistakes investors are making, let's just talk about, well, let's call this the biggest mistake. Talk, and no action, right? So the biggest mistake is you're in a Facebook group, you're in a local investor group, you bought a program, and you're not actually investing. Now, some caution is wise. So I'm not picking on someone if they're in that information gathering stage and they're educating themselves, because that is critical. Because the world, television, media, has presented real estate investing, certainly over the bulk of my lifetime, as this cool thing that smart, savvy people do to make easy money, quote, on the side, right? And the reality is, I know very, very few people that have built real wealth easily with real estate investing. Now, I know a lot of people that have made a lot of money investing in real estate. The difference is the level of intention and focus and commitment and work and education, meaning commitment to grow and learn, that they've put into it. So there, the world is full of a bunch of all talk, no action, wannabe investors. And to be honest, those people are pretty frustrating because they eat up a lot of time and attention of real estate agents and lenders, title companies, inspectors, appraisers, all that stuff. And they don't do a whole lot. So number one mistake is lots and lots of talk and puffed out chests and not a lot of action. I would say next biggest mistake is not specializing. And what I mean by that is very similar to what I just said. You really don't know what kind of investor you are. When I say real estate investing, that is not necessarily a small piece of the pie. That's its own very, very, very large pie. It's like saying I'm a businessman. It doesn't mean much. Are you a real estate investor in single family long-term rental, single family short-term rental, 1-4 family? Like, are you duplex, triplex, fourplex? Are you big multifamily? Are you vacation property? Are you commercial? Are you industrial? Are you land? Are you wholesaling? Are you flipping? Are you wholetailing? Are you Burr method? And there's about 87 other items. There's about 870 other items I could talk about. And by the way, there's a binder and a program you could buy or an online course on every single one of those things times 1,000. And I'm not making fun of the courses or those categories. I'm saying for someone to say, no, I do all of that is completely delusional. To be good at any one of those things, you need to pick one or two. I would certainly say no more than three, especially in the beginning, and learn a ton and get some deals under your belt in that one area, because you're going to make mistakes and you're going to learn. In order to be a truly effective real estate investor, I call that your appetite. You need to know your appetite. My appetite is properties between this price and that price, in this zip code, but not that zip code, this size, but not that size, with this timetable, but not that timetable, that requires this kind of work, but not that kind of work, with this kind of tenant, but not those kind of tenants. And we're not talking about discrimination. We're talking about what you understand and you can effectively manage, take care of, lead, guide, fund, all these things. I mean, it is not at all uncommon to see investors who specialize in picking up deals from other failed investors, half done flips. I got this under contract and I can't figure it out. Can you bail me out? So am I making sense?
Yeah. And we've had people reach out to us in that exact situation.
All the time.
Which is like, man, I bought this and I intended to do this and now I can't afford to do this. Now I need to get it sold. I need to sell it to another investor.
I thought this was going to take 6 weeks. I've had it for 5 months.
Yep.
Yeah. So those are the biggest mistakes. There are many, many, many others. Now, I will say this. If you have the funding and you're clear on what you want, man, our team helps those kinds of investors in a big way. We will help you sell homes for more than you ever thought you could sell them for. Now, we're not talking lowest commission. We're talking about marketing and value. We'll help you acquire homes that have a very high likelihood of the ability to add value and then recapture that on the marketing side. So if you're thinking about being a committed investor, or if you are a committed investor and you need a great team to help you do that, reach out to us, 214-310-0008 for the Todd Tremonti Home Selling Team, or online, like my son says,
ThatTremontiTeam.com.
We have some great investors that we have been working with for years now.
Yeah.
Like all over the Metroplex, over in Fort Worth, over in Dallas, all over the place. We've had multiple people that we've worked with 4, 5, 6, 7 times. We've helped them buy, we've helped them sell. Like, those are the type of people that we're talking to. I was saying, like, if that's you, we can help you with this.
Right. And we tell people all the time, look, be very, very careful with these big national venture capital backed, I'll buy your house companies. But that concept isn't the worst thing. If you just want to sell your house right now, quick and easy, we'll make you an offer, or one of our buyers will make you an offer. And this group of investors that Ian's talking about, they're on that list as well. If you are a committed, legitimate, repeat investor and you'd like to be on that list, reach out as well, 214-310-0008. And if you're a home seller and you would honestly be okay selling your home at somewhat of a discount and just to get it over with quickly, we'll help you get the best offer you can in an all cash situation like that as well. ToddTremontiTeam.com. Now, Patrick, if someone wanted to finance that kind of a transaction, hey, I want to buy it really quickly, help somebody get out of a pinch, and I might have some opportunity there. Does that even exist now?
It does. That's a great question. And it's something we're seeing more of by the day. And that is somebody who comes in with a project that they started. This might be a builder that wasn't able to keep their doors open. This might be an investor that started into a project and it's not finished. And so in the eyes of a lender, in the eyes of Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, they look at this and they say, our collateral is not complete. And so there's this area of limbo where the home needs to reach a completed status before it's eligible for financing. But we do have renovation products, construction loans that can come in and take that property that may not be ready to go in the eyes of the lenders and give them a pathway to get that work done, finance that if needed, and have a finished product that they're ready to move into, sell, whatever the case may be. Basically resolving the issue and bringing it back to market.
Yeah, and listen, my wife and I for 20 years now have never one time done a residential mortgage with anybody other than Patrick Glaros and his team. Now, there's been two occasions where there was a product that you didn't personally have and you introduced me to someone that did have it and they took great care of us. So my recommendation is, regardless of what you need in the realm of financing property, you call Patrick Glaros first, and you call him at
972-728-3420.
NMLS number 308.
We all wanted to get it on that one. 972-728-3420, or you can always go to ToddTremontiTeam.com. All right, we got all kinds of stuff to cover as we make our way through the show, but if you don't know the condition of your roof right now, I know this sounds silly. Sounds like I'm just hyping a roofing company. But if you don't know that your roof is in good shape, then you're not prepared to enter the fall with lots of rain and potential hail and even snow and ice as we get into the winter. And the thing is that your roof covers all the other things. It covers the sheetrock and the insulation and the electrical and the wood floors and the tile and your family and the kitchen.
It's fair to say it covers the whole house.
That's a reasonable thing to say, Ian. I appreciate that contribution. Here's the thing. I'm not being crazy here. It's better to have like an $87 repair than an $8,700 massive repair. or a $15,000 roof. So if you haven't had someone on your roof in the last couple of years, I want you to reach out to PMR Roofing right now. You can just go to PMRroofing.com. You can email Jordan at PMRroofing.com, or you can call the office 469-409-ROOF, or roof if you want to say it like David Goss does, 469-409-ROOF. Ask for Jordan Collins. They will look you in the eye, shake your hand, help you with what you need help with, and not sell you anything that you do not need. PMRroofing.com.
And if you haven't checked out your home valuation, if you have no idea what your home is worth, we have made it so easy for you. Go to TodTremontiTeam.com, click the home valuation tab, and in less than a minute, it will tell you what your home is worth. It's going to give you equity. It's going to tell you all sorts of information about how you can get cash offers, how you can get price analysis, all sorts of things. Just go to TodTremontiTeam.com, click the home valuation tab, and you will get your home valuation in less than a minute.
Love it. Love it. All kinds of things at the website. You can take a home buyer readiness quiz. You can take a home seller readiness quiz. You can search all homes for sale by all real estate agents in all of DFW. All of it.
Just a fun place to go.
It's just, you know, just internet good time.
Yeah.
TodTremontiTeam.com. Courtney, be careful, sister. All right, here we go. As we get later in the show, we're going to dig really deep with Patrick on some new financing options that you have got to know about. And we're also going to dig deep on how those might impact your ability to purchase and enjoy a home on some acreage. Now, I want to talk about a couple of things happening over at one of my projects that Patrick's about to finance in a second. But before that, anything we need to cover over here?
I know.
All right. So here's the thing. I've got a PMR roof sitting on my new build property. I've got a Reinhardt Service Company electrical, heating, and air conditioning system that's being polished up. By the way, Patrick's the one that introduced me to the Reinhardt crew, I don't know, 15 years ago.
I think so.
He was joking on site the other day about watching my kids grow up, which is weird to hear from your AC and electrical guy, but we've done a lot of work together over the years. And so here's the thing. We practice what we preach. We are not going to tell you about a company on this show that we're not using. So if you're thinking, who do I need for that? Who can I trust for that? Go to TodTremontiTeam.com, click that radio tab. And if someone's name, phone number, email, website is on there, we're using them. We have used them, or at least lots of our clients have used them and been really, really happy with them. That doesn't mean these people are 100% perfect and everything's, you know, perfect, perfect, perfect every single day, all the time. I cannot promise that. I can tell you these are the best folks we have found anywhere in DFW, and they are doing things on my house, on my homes, on our office, on our properties, all, you know, all the time, literally on a weekly basis for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds, thousands of clients over the years. If you need anything, go to TodTremontiTeam.com, click that radio tab, find those vendors, search homes, figure out your home equity or your property value right there. Now, when we come back from the break, we're going to dig in deep on some new mortgage items, some homes on land information, and your questions. So send your questions in right now. We'll cover them here in just a minute. 214-310-0008 or anything online, TodTremontiTeam.com. Patrick, real quick before we go to the break, how do you feel about SMU and the new conference?
It's exciting. I'm glad to be in the conversation and not left on the wayside. So let's go, Ponies.
As a Baylor fan, I feel that at my core. All right, folks, we'll be right back after this with a lot more DFW Real Estate Weekly. If you miss us live, find the podcast wherever you listen to podcasts. DFW Real Estate Weekly with Todd Tremonti.
Giggum.
What's up, party people? We are rocking and rolling in the Keene Landscaping Studio. Full house in here. Mike's moving all over the place. Patrick Glaros himself, live, in person, in studio, bringing the wisdom. More for you to come here shortly. But if you've got a question, you know the drill. You should already have this phone number saved in your cellular phone, in your mobile phone, 214-310-0008. You should have that saved under Todd Tremonti, Todd Tremonti Broker, Realtor, Team, whatever you're into, but you should have it saved. 214-310-0008. Call or text. Don't be afraid to text. If you call, you might get to hear the soothing tones of the English wonder himself, the Yanni Donny Ian Daniels. If you text, you will not hear the accent, but you might still get to communicate with Ian Daniels.
Unless you read the text with an accent in your head.
As I do when you text me. It's a privilege either way, folks. 214-310-0008. We got a lot to cover. Let's get into it. Oh, yep. Got him again.
Researching again. This first segment of the second half of the show is, as always, brought to you by Patrick Gloros and his team at Cardinal Financial. Like I've said for years now, if you're looking to get a mortgage, you're looking to refinance, maybe you're looking for a second property. We talked about investing on the first half of the show today. PatrickGloros.com is a great first place to go. You can also call him at 972-728-3420. PatrickGloros.com, G-L-A-R-O-S, PatrickGloros.com, NMLS number 308804. Yeah! Let's talk about one of your favorite topics, Todd. Homes on land.
God, they're so beautiful. Now, here's the thing. It's a joke around the office that it's like my obsession, but it is. And I know I'm not alone. Many of you in DFW have reached out to us already saying that is a goal of mine that I'd like to achieve a year from now, 2 years from now, when the kids get to this certain age, or when we have children, or when I retire, or whatever the case is. And it has long been a conversation of Patrick's and mine, as we both are the kind of people that like to get out onto some land, into some space, hunt, fish, and play. Most people in the DFW area are not quite talking hunting land, farm and ranch land. They're looking at a big backyard, whether that's an acre, 2 acres, maybe five. So let me volley this question over to you. If I were wanting to buy, let's just say two acres with a house already on it, is there anything different about the financing of that versus a house in a neighborhood?
There really is not anything to be concerned about or afraid of if that's the type of property that you're looking for. Lenders view that as a property on land. The difference of how much acreage or how much the property is usually does not come into play unless you have some massive, extremely valuable acreage with a little shack or house on it. Then it can become an issue of being highest and best use. But otherwise, the loan itself to buy that property is going to be exactly the same as if you were buying in a regular neighborhood.
Yep. And that's what I want people to know, is that really what we're talking about is a giant yard. Even if it's 5 acres, that loan is for the house and the land that comes with it, and there will be a value placed on it. And in my experience with the thousands of clients we've worked with over the years, is that it's a little bit easier to hit that value because the appraiser, the buyer, have all of this expansive land to look at and see there's a lot more value here, as opposed to the traditional approach where it's a 1/5 acre lot or maybe even a 1/4 acre lot, and the lot is just really not even a major part of the conversation. Of course, it gets calculated on the comparisons and all those things, but the reality is this. When you have that additional land, you have additional value, you have additional use. Patrick's reference to highest and best use is you might find yourself in a situation where literally the methodology that's used to value it is different because it may be more or occasionally less valuable as something other than a home for farm and ranch or for commercial use or something like that. But the 998 out of 1,000 people that we work with that say homes on land are thinking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 acres, and they're thinking same old simple loan. I can get in there the same as I could get into the house I bought in a neighborhood. But is there anything new? Is there anything different? You know, a lot of these are people buying it and they're wanting to improve something. They wanted to add a barn, add a garage, add a pool, chicken coop, or addition to the house, pour some concrete driveway, you know, whatever. What if I want to do that? Now, are there any, is it the same old mortgage and I just have to save up my cash, or how could I do that?
Well, we're going to have to get in a time machine and go back to the days good old of days. A program we used to call a Purchase Plus.
So great.
And really what this allows somebody to do is buy a home on land or not and be able to finance in the improvements that they're looking to do into that mortgage. And so they'll work with a contractor, they'll get their bids and plans for what they want to do to make the house where they want it to be in the end. And we get to take that and build it all in at the front. This doesn't have to be something that happens over the next decade. It can, certainly. But this is something that we can implement and put in place and have that dream come to fruition right out of the gate.
Yeah. So if we don't have a time machine, is that type of loan available right now?
The beautiful thing is we brought it back.
Heyo.
To today. So that renovation product, that remodel product is available now and Sweet. Can be done on regular properties or on acreage. I mean, there's some folks that are using these to go in, buy that land, buy that acreage, and convert the barn into the barn dominium.
Love it.
So those fit. Tiny houses fit. Really what it comes down to is, does the property conform? Is there another tiny house on some land out there? If we can answer,
it's gotta
yes.
It's got to be like on a slab though, right? That tiny house?
That's okay. Right.
Yeah.
So I know some people are going to be asking this themselves, like, is there a premium that people have to pay to be able to do something like that? Is it like an astronomical amount that somebody has to do, or is it something that's fairly affordable?
That's the great news, is there are programs that fit kind of regardless of the scope of work. There's some that fit with folks that are just wanting to add in an appliance package from a big box store, and they can have that be their only add-in. And it can be all the way from that ground up construction. Now, the terms might not be exactly the same, just because this is something that the loan is going to cover the closing and through the completion of that work that's being done. So the more extensive the work is, the longer it may take to complete. That may add a slight premium to the interest rate. But I think the name of the game with the interest rate is that part's temporary. The opportunity is being able to capture that land, capture that value as it sits today. We don't like where interest rates are today, but we like the result of what these higher interest rates have done to the market. And it doesn't mean that prices have gone down, but it means that we have more opportunity today in this market than we did at any point in the last few years.
Well, let's talk a little bit more about that, because the economic data is negative, but the home values that we're seeing are still really strong.
Phoenix the intern, did you hear that? It was a big butt segment. I know you've been excited about this one. The economic data is negative. It's pessimistic. It says that we're heading into a nightmare situation, blah, 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 on the majority. But there's a massive opportunity for home buyers right now. There's a tremendous amount of opportunity. The real estate values are healthy. And I'm going to define healthy for everybody. It may not be healthy if values are going up 23% in 1 year. It's definitely not healthy for most of us if they're going down at all. But what we're seeing this year and the bulk of last year is a slow and steady climb of property values, which feels like a major downshift from 2020, 2021, where it was an unbelievably rapid uptick. So instead of 1% or 2% per month, we might have 1% or 2% per quarter, which is still pretty attractive. So to translate a little bit of what Patrick is saying from a lender's perspective, from a real estate perspective, there is a lot of positives. Mortgage rates going up is not fun. Let's just acknowledge that. A higher payment isn't fun. But would I trade that for not having to compete with 37 buyers? Would I trade that for a seller who's now willing to work with me a little bit, who before was like, take a hike my way or the highway? And would I trade it for a few more options, a little bit more housing inventory, and some creative lenders like Cardinal Financial and Patrick and his team that are now going, hey, we'll help you figure this out. If you want to buy the land and the 3-bedroom house and turn that into a 4 or 5-bedroom house, buy the land and the barn and turn that into a home, buy the land and add a home, whatever the case is, we have a loan program for you, and the interest rate is palatable. Not necessarily like, oh my gosh, jump all over that, but I can live with that because I don't have to deal with all these other negatives, and maybe I can refinance that rate down if it comes lower later, but also I don't have to go and get 2 or 3 different loans. I can get it all rolled into one, and a slight little bump in rate is probably worth it for the convenience of having all that rolled into one package and actually achieving my goal. The difference in not achieving it and achieving it is massive. And I personally am willing to deal with a rate I don't love, but it is doable for now.
Well, and we've been saying this feels like all year, and it probably has been all year that we've been saying this, right? But what I've noticed in the last, I would say, 4 to 6 weeks is we've had more and more sellers reaching back out to us saying, we're now ready to go and sell our home. And we've had more and more buyers raising their hands and saying, I think I've come to the realization that
it's not going to change.
It is what it is
right now. So I don't want to get in when it gets worse, and I can always redo something when it gets better. So let me just go ahead and get into the housing market, because that, and I've just seen so many more people in this last 6 weeks or so that have come to that realization.
Yeah, we've been saying that for multiple years. Now, let me just do an old radio tease. Not yet. But I'm going to ask Patrick the most unfair question that you can ask a lender on the air here in a little bit. And I'm just going to ask him to safely predict what he thinks is going to happen the rest of the year or early next year with rates. I'll give the disclaimer before him. Nobody knows. But Patrick follows this as closely as anybody I know, and I trust his opinion more than anyone I know. So we're going to ask him in the next 4 or 5 minutes. So stay with us. You're listening to DFW Real Estate with Todd Tremonti. If you miss any of this live, check out the podcast wherever you get podcasts. It's called DFW Real Estate Weekly with Todd Tremonti. Really big, really long name, so it's easy to search for. Tell your friends, tell your family, folks that are moving here, folks that are moving within the area. We provide bonus episodes over there, so you're catching way more than what we do here live on the show. DFW Real Estate Weekly with Todd Tremonti. Find it anywhere you find podcasts. Also, all over YouTube. Just search my name, Todd Tremonti, on YouTube. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of videos with educational content there, as well as a video of the show there as well.
RepublicTitle.com. Republic Title are one of the leaders in the title industry. It's definitely who we trust. I've told you for years, a bad title company is just destructive to the entire transaction. It makes things so difficult, and it can be, frankly, dangerous to the person that's buying the home if it's not a reputable, trustworthy title company with years and years of experience. Republic Title, check all the boxes. 972-423-8777. RepublicTitle.com is where you can go to find out all the information about what they offer. RepublicTitle.com. Now, before we get to Patrick's Nostradamus predictions,
he's a soothsayer, really.
I have what I'm on good word told is Patrick's favorite segment of this show, and he's so excited to get to participate, Courtney, in the Cockney Rhyming Slang Word of the Week.
Here we go.
Ready? Let's go. Okay, there we go. Ready? Today's word, Patrick, that you have to, I'm going to give you, I know how you know how this works, but for people that haven't heard this before, I'm going to give you the Cockney Rhyming Slang, and I need your prediction as to what it actually means. Are we ready?
Also, sidebar, they don't always rhyme.
Ready? Jam jar.
A jam jar?
A jam jar.
A little bitty car.
It is car.
Yay!
See, you're getting good at this.
I'm actually...
We should have let the guest guess first. But
nope,
okay.
I knew it. I had
too
felt
much conviction
it.
There.
I felt it in my bones. Here's the thing. It's always harder to say the slang than the actual thing.
I got a bonus one for you.
Literally makes no sense.
I'm going to give you a bonus, and I'm going to let you be the one that
gets it. It's like a shortcut that takes three times as long as the normal.
Let me see if I can short-circuit my brain here.
Okay. Duke of Kent. Duke of Kent.
A gent.
Nope, not a gent. It is rent.
Who in the world would be like, the Duke of Kent is due?
But they get shortened down. It's like, oh man, I gotta go pay my Duke this week.
Oh, my Duke.
Okay, so it's a rhyming slang that gets shortened.
You have the whole thing, and then you can shorten it, and then once you get in the lingo of it, then we're good to go, you know?
The Duke is an abbreviation for something very different in this country.
Yeah, you know, dinky-doos, shoes. I like your dinkies.
Okay, don't waste them. Don't waste them.
I've got lots of these.
Yeah, actually, go ahead. Waste them all.
Nah, I want to make sure you... I don't want to give too much to the audience.
Please waste...
Be done with it.
I don't want to give too much.
Burn it down.
Hey, what are you reading and thinking about right now, Todd?
I'm reading a book right now. Now, just to be clear for our listeners, we do a lot of show prep around here, and by that I mean a little show prep, and we do not prep for this segment at all. So I'm currently reading a book called The Hypomanic Edge. It's a super fascinating book, mostly about entrepreneurship, but it's also, as it walks through the brain of the typical entrepreneur, it's a story of America. This sounds crazy, but it's really fascinating. So hypermanic would be like manic depressive or bipolar, right? Hypo is like slightly manic, like people that are really intense. And so the book is about entrepreneurs and entrepreneurial thinkers. So it's been through like Andrew Carnegie and the founders of this country and industrialists and other things like that, where these people are thought of either to be highly, highly gifted and some place overly intense. But the idea is that this, it's not a weakness or an illness. It's a gift when used correctly. And it's been really, really fascinating as a business owner and leader and sort of builder of things. I don't think I'm to the extreme like some of these incredible world builders, but it's been interesting to think about how I think about things and how others think about things. So the book is called The Hypomanic Edge. And here's the fascinating point that would, I think, interest most people. The idea of immigration or emigration, depending on which side of the move you're thinking about, is fascinating that America is a nation of immigrants who were instinctively the most hypomanic in the countries that they left. They left to pursue something greater. They left because they believed that they could build something here. And so you have a country that is wildly higher in percentage of hypomanic people, because that's the kind of people that leave other countries to cross nations and oceans and come and build something here. So then you have generations of children of one or two hypomanic parents or grandparents, and you have this growing building like culture that is itself hypomanic. And so that's kind of the theory of the book. It's really, really fascinating that we are one of the most unique cultures in the history of the world because of this idea of people that want to somewhat obsessively build, fix, and improve things, which is why initially a very, very small population in America took a leadership position in the global economy, global culture, global leadership, geopolitical, all these things. And now kind of sits at a crossroads. So anyway, a really, really fascinating book. That's what's been on my mind lately, how we can have positive change in our company, in our world, in our communities, because of a little bit of how I'm wired, but also understanding how our culture and our population is wired. So how about that?
And now on to Nostradamus Kleros with his predictions for the rest of the year.
So far, I'd like to just give you a 10 out of 10 on your pronunciation of all the words this morning. Nostradamus, Kleros, I mean, it's been fascinating. I love it. Okay.
Pretty solid.
Here's the question. What are rates going to do, mortgage rates going to do, end of 2023, beginning of 2024? I'll give the disclaimer. Nobody knows. But in 1 minute or less, what are you looking at and what do you think the indications are?
That's right. The disclaimer, you saw me take the crystal ball to the shop. Yep. It's yet out of the shop.
It's always a good one-liner.
But I do feel like most of the damage has been done with rising interest rates on the mortgage side. Now, I don't feel like interest rates are all of a sudden just going to fall back down and go to 3% or 4%. But I do feel like we have seen the majority of the increase in rates. Right now, where we sit, rates have matched the high levels that we got to last year. And the fact that we have just matched those levels is encouraging. That might sound counterintuitive, but the fact that we have matched those levels and not broken through to higher rates at this point in time is a good sign.
20 seconds.
I feel like the 10-year Treasury is going to be something that is crucial to watch. I feel like we're going to see that pull back, and we're going to see interest rates in the sixes, possibly by the end of the year, and maybe into the fives by next year.
Whoa. There you go. Whoa, hot take.
Guaranteed.
And in under a minute. Well done, sir. In under 1 minute, the only thing that thousands of people listening heard was in the sixes by the end of the year, maybe in the fives early next year. That's the no one even heard 10-year Treasury. No one heard anything else. That's the world we live in. Give me the rate. So I'll add the 17th disclaimer. I've never trusted anybody with mortgage advice more than Patrick Kleros and his team. Even if that's not right, you're going to get the best, most accurate on the ground. What do I do for my family, my finances, buying, financing, refinancing, selling, investing, that you can get from Patrick Kleros and his team? Go to patrickkleros.com. That's G-L-A-R-O-S, patrickkleros.com, or they can call you where?
972-728-3420.
Right. NMLS number 308-804.
Keeping it legal. All right, here's the deal, folks. I talked in the first half of the show, but if you missed it, here's your summary version. You got to know the condition of your roof. It covers all the things. It's not fun. It's not exciting, but it's smart. So call PMR Roofing, 469-409-ROOF or 469-409-ROOF if you're into that pronunciation. Either way, call PMR Roofing or go to PMRroofing.com. They're as good as it gets, honest as it comes, fair with pricing, excellent at what they do. They just put a brand new roof on my place, and they should put one on yours if you need it. But even if you don't need it, you need to know the condition of your roof, especially before we head into fall and winter. 469-409-ROOF or PMRroofing.com. Ask for Jordan.
And if you haven't checked your home valuation recently, go to ToddTremontyTeam.com, click the home valuation tab, and in less than a minute, you will be able to see what your home is worth. It's going to give you a bunch of options for how to reach out if you want a cash offer. If you're thinking about selling, it's going to give you some more options on like how to reach out to us, things you can ask us. Go to ToddTremontyTeam.com, click the home valuation tab.
All right. During the break, between the segments, during news, traffic, and weather today, we were talking a little bit about youth sports. And I know that producer Courtney finds it important that we get a little bit off the real estate trail every once in a while on the show and just talk a little bit about life and things that are important to us. So we were having a little bit of fun talking about Patrick bumping into Courtney out on the athletic field. I was having a deeper conversation with a friend of mine this week about, should I keep coaching my kids? The advantage of having someone else coach and lead and set an example for your children, for them to learn to trust authority and discipline, all the unbelievably rich, lasting benefits of sports. The trophies don't last. The wins and losses, truthfully, in my opinion, in youth sports, you know, until high school, really don't matter at all. That's not even why I recommend that we be out there. And as a Christ follower, I'll just be really, really honest and direct. If you don't share my faith, by all means, find the application there for you. Love to talk to you about that. But here's the thing. If your kiddo is on the mound or in the batter's box or with the ball for a penalty kick or playing quarterback or whatever the case is, and things go well or things don't go well, my hope, my prayer is that the conversation on the way home is the same. I love watching you play. You're awesome. And we don't find our value in wins and losses on the athletic field, right? So I was talking to a buddy, and he was just talking about how they think about this in their home. His kiddo had an opportunity to go pitch in the final inning of a championship game, and he was sitting in the stands thinking, if we win, I need to remind my son that his value is in the fact that he was wonderfully and fearfully created by the Lord, by God. And if he loses, it's the exact same thing. Hey, buddy. Good job out there. Didn't go our way today. That's not where your value is. Your value is in that God created you and that your mother and I love you and that you're incredible and we think you're great and all these things. And so that's my nugget for today on youth sports. You may feel differently. Wonderful thing is we live in a free country. But where I would challenge parents, because I get to see a lot of sports out there and I get to see a lot of people who are, I don't even think consciously, trying to achieve some success that maybe they once did not achieve through their kids. And I'm watching their kids not enjoy it. And I'm watching their kids not learn and grow. And honestly, sometimes become punks and brats. So I love you all. You don't have to share my faith, but my encouragement to you is to use these opportunities for our kids to learn and grow and to remind them of what is most valuable, what will last beyond the athletic field and hopefully beyond this lifetime. So that's my thoughts and my opinion. Check out the podcast, DFW Real Estate Weekly, wherever you get podcasts. Check out the YouTube channel. All of it is online at ToddTremontyTeam.com.